Hit the subscribe button or visit us at auau.auanet.org.
Laparoscopic and robotic level 2 and 3 IVC thrombectomy, vascular control techniques. Our aim in this video is to present the feasibility of distinct IVC vascular control techniques for level 2 and 3 tumor thrombus, IVC cross-clamping, IVC interruption, and cavectomy. IVC cross-clamping may be indicated for level 2 or 3 tumor thrombus in the absence of bland thrombus and a low suspicion of IVC wall invasion. The technique consists in clamping the contralateral renal vein, proximal IVC and distal IVC, followed by IVC incision and tumor thrombus dislodgement. First case is a robotic level 2 IVC tumor thrombectomy using the IVC cross-clamping technique. CT scan shows us a 6.2 cm mixed hypodense right tumor associated to a level 2 IVC tumor thrombus. Patients placed in the left flank position and the robot is docked. Left renal vein and lumbar veins are properly identified during IVC dissection. The right renal artery is identified and early divided in the interaortal caval space, avoiding possible neovascularization close to the kidney tumor. Inferior vena cava vascular control is achieved by sequentially applying Romeo tourniquets in distal IVC, left renal vein, and proximal IVC. The divided right renal artery stump is retrieved. Romeo tourniquets are closed. First distal IVC, followed by left renal vein, and finally proximal IVC. Security bulldogs are applied in distal IVC and left renal vein. Frozen image highlights the already controlled left renal vein, distal and proximal IVC, and shows right renal vein and tumor thrombus. Inferior vena cava is vertically incised, followed by tumor thrombus removal and IVC closure using a 5-0 proline running suture. IVC interruption may be indicated for level 2 or 3 tumor thrombus in the presence of bland thrombus and a low suspicion of IVC wall invasion. For this technique, contralateral renal vein and proximal IVC are controlled and clamped. Distal IVC is stapled, preventing bland thrombus dislodgement. The IVC is incised and tumor thrombus is delivered. Here, we present a case of IVC interruption in a left side level 3 IVC tumor thrombus. MRI shows us an 8 cm left renal mass, along with a level 3B tumor thrombus going up to the major hepatic veins and bland thrombus extending until left iliac vein. Key step for left side tumors is to early staple the left renal vein and complete left nephrectomy before patient repositioning. For the IVC thrombectomy, patient is repositioned in left flank position. Some new parts are added for trocar placement and the robot is redocked. Inferior vena cava dissection is carried on. The left renal vein stump is retrieved. The distal IVC is circumferentially dissected, followed by IVC interruption using the stapler. Retrohepatic IVC dissection is carried on, and short hepatic veins are divided in order to allow proper caudate lobe mobilization. Right renal vein is identified and clamped. proximal IVC control is achieved using a bulldog clamp. The IVC is incised and thrombectomy is done. Notice the evident presence of tumor thrombus and bland thrombus in this case. Cavectomy, indicated in the presence of bland thrombus associated to a high suspicion of IVC wall invasion. Distal IVC, proximal IVC, and contralateral renal vein are stapled, and the specimen is removed in block along with the kidney. Here we present a laparoscopic cavectomy for right side level 3 IVC tumor thrombus. CT scan shows us a 6 cm right renal mass, along with a level 3B IVC tumor thrombus and a bland thrombus extending until bilateral iliac veins. The right renal artery is clipped and divided. Inferior vena cava is circumferentially dissected. Left renal vein is identified and controlled. Short hepatic veins are ligated for better exposure. Proximal IVC is circumferentially dissected and controlled using vessel loops. The highlighted image shows the dissected distal inferior vena cava and left renal artery. Distal IVC and left renal vein are clamped. Proximal IVC is stapled. Distal IVC is also stapled. A second shot was necessary for a complete transection. A safety suture is applied in the distal IVC stump. Finally, left renal vein is divided. The specimen is removed in block.